And welcome to That's Crap Detection, the toolkit. I'm your host, Dean Venderman. Today we're going to be talking about biases. So on the sheet, I mean, there's different possible biases. It could be something that the author is influenced, or they're looking for financial gain or political gain, or there might be, you know, other biases that too. So did you examine the choice of words? So when we take a look here at this site, I think this site is really great, and I've also included it into the Wakelet as well. How basically biases might have a leaning towards one thing. So, you know, sometimes what's not said is just more important than what is said, you know, when you're looking at if facts were omitted or not. What additional information would be necessary? Was it have a positive or a negative impression? You know, could you use different words? Words are really important, and they definitely can sway you one way or another. And basically, you could have the same kind of topic, but definitely the words you choose can have definitely a huge effect. You know, what are some of the indicators of biases on a web page? Like, is there extreme language? Is it all or nothing? Does it try to get your emotions in there rather than just sticking to the facts? You know, are things even oversimplified or generalized that just kind of you wonder what's beneath the surface? You know, does the author just trying to limit you to what they're thinking? You know, so always try to see what people's political point of view is, what the author stands again, who's paying for the website. Like we talked in the last episode about the web page extensions can help you with that a little bit too. And are there alternate points of view, right? Or is it just one-sided? I know one really great source too that I really like to take a peek at is this site too, which again is in the resources. And it basically shows you from the different news sites, whether they're to the right or to the left or in the middle. So when you're viewing something like if you have something from CNN, for example, you might take a look at the here and see where CNN is a little bit on the left. Where if you have something, say, for example, from Fox News, right, when you take a look at the link here, you can see that Fox News is more on the right. So when you're reading these things, you can kind of maybe see where biases might lie within websites themselves. So biases are really interesting to take a look at. You know, sometimes was there an error, yes or no? Was that mistake done on purpose? Or do you think it was intentional misconduct, to really understand where biases are? Biases is almost, to be human is to have a bias almost. So we always kind of check and see where that is for sure. So thanks for watching another episode of That's Crap Detection, the Toolkit. I'm your host, Dean Betterman. And until next time, know your crap. Detection.